Hello, everyone. God bless you all. I just pray that you're all doing well right now in these times. I just wanted to start off by saying why we attended this event, this protest that was happening. We came to support, to convict, to edify, to encourage everyone that was there. And our hearts were not in a place of condemnation, but it was a place to bring clarity to those who are lost in sin and worldliness. And with everyone, we wanted to direct them to the truth of the matter, to help them see that we need to forgive those who have opposed us, to honor and respect the authorities that help keep us safe in this country. We still need police officers. You know, starting riots will not help the cause. Yes, it's great to have a voice and to be heard, but it needs to be done with wisdom, not with a hardened heart. The gospel of Jesus Christ needs to be preached. Black lives matter, but all souls matter. We thought this would be a great opportunity since the crowd of people was large. We plan to plant the seeds, and the Lord will give the increase. And whoever has an ear to hear, let them hear. We were not only preaching, but also one-on-one evangelizing with groups and in prayers to those who were hurting. And we did not want to record them because we didn't want their hearts to be closed off towards the message. Because this is not about us, nor this is about our works. This is about helping others seek Jesus Christ to save them from eternal damnation. We know that the time is short. We all need to step in together in unity to spread the good news of our Lord and Savior. And however the Lord leads us to, there are many ways, and we are still all learning. We're all maturing to be effective in the body of Christ. We need to rise up and do our part, because He is worthy of all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. Blessed be the name of Jesus Christ. I pray you all have a beautiful, blessed day in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. too.
Jesus Christ is dead. You have been freely given, so now freely give. Amen. So now I give to you the word of Christ, the truth. See, you will say that black lives matter. I say all lives matter.
Hallelujah.
Black. See, it's about equality. And I understand that you want your justice to be served. But God said that vengeance is his. Revenge belongs to the Lord. He will repay. Not you.
Yes.
Because guess what? Revenge. Revenge will lead you to only more revenge. See, it's not going to profit you anything that you lose your soul and you gain the whole world. You go around vandalizing, you go around stealing and sinning before a holy God, and you think you're doing him a favor. And the majority of people will not even think that you're doing God a favor, because you are in your sin, going off of your emotions, going off of your flesh. Bible says that those who are in the flesh cannot please God. So if you participate in this stealing and from stores, and you participate in vandalizing property, then you are not pleasing God. You are in your flesh, in your sin, dead in your trespasses, that you will need to repay. But let me tell you, there's a hope out here today that I preach, and it's the hope of Jesus Christ. Because he says that his hope is that you have to trust in the Lord Jesus Christ. Not going on your own emotions. Not going upon what your father or what your mother has taught you, or what society has taught you. But you go upon what the Lord has already said. The Bible says that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. So that means his words are not going to change. His character is not going to change. Nothing is going to change with the Lord. He says the same. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bless the Lord. Praise the Lord. His word shall always be on my lips.
For going upon your flesh, for
listening to your wicked heart. The Bible says that the heart is wicked above all things. Who should know it? And many of you have followed your heart. You have followed what you have, what you know to be true, what you think is true. Not what God has already spoken and has done around for centuries. You have gone upon your flesh. You cannot please God with your flesh. You can only please God with obedience. So please stop lying. Stop doing these things that you think are going to fix your society. Let me tell you, the Lord can only heal your land.
Hallelujah.
Not your outward rebellious acts. The Lord is far greater above all names, everybody. Far greater above any act that you do. Do not think that the logical approach, the reason behind your doings is going to literally fix your society. Your society will not be fixed unless you repent, unless you humble yourself, unless you turn to God. That's what you need to do. I see a lot of Black Lives Matter signs. I don't see any praise the Lord Jesus Christ signs.
Hallelujah.
That's what should it be about.
Hallelujah.
It should be about the Lord. It should always be about the Lord. You should always be about your Father's business.
Hallelujah.
Always, at all times, do not catch him slipping. The Bible says that the Lord is going to come back like a thief in the night. Don't get caught off track. Don't be sleeping when he comes back, when the housekeeper comes back, and you're sleeping. Ooh, he's not going to take you. He's not going to take you with him to the promised land, to heaven. He's not going to take you because you're still dead in your sin. He's going to take his obedient, righteous, servant. That's who he's going to take. Now, another thing, what I don't understand is, all of these people have freedom of speech out here today, but when I go downtown, right, I don't have freedom of speech. I don't get to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ, because people hate that. They hate the word of Jesus Christ. Because you hate God. God has made the world. Jesus Christ is all about that. Are you going to make this up? Are you going to make this up? That's what I thought. That's what I thought.
Amen. Hallelujah.
That's what I thought. You're not going to do anything. Want to know why? Because the Lord protected me. That's why. A lot of people are
all lives matter. All lives.
You may be pro-LGBT, but does that please God? No, it doesn't. What pleases God? Obedience to God. People can threaten me, you can do what you want to do. That doesn't mean anything to me. I don't fear you. I don't fear man.
Hallelujah.
I fear the Lord Jesus Christ. Who do you fear? Who do you fear? How is it that you fear God? Or do you fear men?
Hallelujah. Really?
I just contacted him last night. I was like, bro, can we straight preach and stuff?
Hallelujah! Let's go!
It's a God movement.
All lives
Jesus
matter.
Jesus died for everyone!
Hallelujah!
There's no Jew, no Gentile, slave or free!
Hallelujah!
Period!
Oh God, they're going to make us creatures of men! And so I'm out here today to get some fish! Save some sinners!
Hallelujah!
Save some sinners from hell, to bring back some prodigal sons, to bring back some reprobates, some people that have gone astray.
God is people right that have here.
He's right here.
Period. God is fighting for you.
Who have been led astray by what?
He is not.
By the deception of the
devil. Hallelujah!
Stay focused, people.
He doesn't pick at you.
It's not about that. It's not about his life. It's about the eternal life that Jesus Christ has already given.
Hallelujah, sister.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Where's the true follower of Christ? Hear ye. Hear ye. Where are you at?
Hallelujah.
I'm not seeing anybody. Where's the sheep of God at? Where's the true servants of God? Well, I'm not afraid of anything. From the dead.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah. hear anything. I don't hear anything. Who has risen from the dead?
Jesus.
Who has resurrected from the grave?
Jesus.
Not George Floyd. You know what the Bible says? Just forgive those who have persecuted you. Forgive those. Forgive them. Forgive those people who have done you wrong.
Hey, bro, you'll shut it down. Don't be free.
Forgive them. Forgive these people who have done you wrong.
Man.
Jesus has given you forgiveness. He has offered to you salvation, eternal life.